Deep in the vast desert southwest sits an airplane boneyard. These gleaming aluminum hulks that once plied the skies to distant lands now sit here, awaiting their final demise in the scrap heap. But one among them is rather unique. Its livery tells more than most people could possibly imagine. The name once belonged to a little-known Texas-based carrier called Air America, an air carrier with a dark, shadowy past. Air America and another Texas-based carrier, Southern Air Transport, played pivotal roles in America's secret war.
Highness, there are widespread reports and accusations that the United States has sent troops into Laos and that this was partly responsible for the fighting there. What do you say about these accusations?
This accusation is false and nonsense. We don't have any American troops in Laos.
Some goddamn newspaper guy wanted to get a story to the effect that we were going back in Laos. Because, dude, I said, don't comment on that sort of stuff. Dodge it.
The USAID boys called them rice kickers. And no one knew about our secret war. Not Congress. Not the Senate Foreign Affairs Committee. Least of all, not the American public.
Secret agent man. Secret agent man. They've given you a number.
Except boots on the ground reporters who kept on seeing firsthand evidence. Today, Laos, or La as the locals call it, belies little of its horrific past.
What do you mean by ship dipped?
Well, ship dipped, in an instant you become a CIA officer. You're a Navy SEAL, or for this mission, you become a CIA operative under covert action authority. And it's a bureaucratic trick that allows you to operate in places where you wouldn't normally operate.
As far as American manpower in Laos is concerned, there are none there at the present time on a combat basis.
There are no American combat forces in Laos.
And no one but the president's inner circle knew it was bull.
We do have aerial reconnaissance. We do have perhaps some other activities.
Right about here, but the map doesn't show a town here.
Well, then I guess we're not here. And we don't really run 400 flights a day out of here, or ship 100 tons of cargo, medicine, weapons, platoons of local troops.
We have been providing logistical support and some training.
Any comment on the reports of an escalated American military commitment, reports of larger bombers, B-52s operating? Would you comment on any of that, sir?
Oh, there'd certainly be no comment.
Thank you very much, Mr. Messler.
Why are they shooting at us?
Because they're unfriendly.
Why are they all so unfriendly?
Well, they haven't got to know us yet. Don't worry. I crash better than anyone I know.
Oh! Oh!
United States Senators, in my backyard, on a goddamn fact-finding mission, no less.
Hey, Senator, let us show you the real Laos.
Pesky reporters kept asking, and eventually the secret war would unravel.
La, 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 la.
Tin
Horn General doing in my Corinne,
camp.
Have you met U.S. Senator Davenport?
Welcome, Senator. I'm Corinne Landreau of USAID.
Noble work, Miss Landreau. This is truly noble work. Look at that little devil operating.
See, a secret war is the way to go.
I don't seem to come here to Shanghai all these men and boys for this private
army. You can't laugh at war. What's the use of fighting, huh?
After all was said and done, we left behind the most bombed country on Earth.
against the best guerrilla army in the world, America replies with massive air power.
But will Americans continue their vast air raids once the war in Vietnam is over? Already, President Nixon is under fire for his war policy in Laos.
I don't care if he goes in and bombs the hell out of them, but don't say it.
Unfortunate legacy of America's secret war is the human toll. Nearly 2 million tons of bombs rained on Laos, more than in all of World War II and Korea. Nearly a third of Laos is littered by unexploded ordnance. And an estimated 20,000 people have been killed or injured from UXO since the war ended.
To continue to fight through the months ahead for my personal vindication would almost totally absorb the time and attention of both the President and the Congress. Therefore, I shall resign the presidency effective at noon tomorrow.
Roger, that completes the checklist. Ready,
ready.
Now,
door is
open. Roger, standing by release.
PDI, sir.
Roger.
Okay, coming up on 0 ship 0 now. 060.
I got the time going. We just 5:41. Stand by to release. Ready, ready, now. Bombs ready.